Hello and welcome to AA's Art Channel. My name is Ilkjan Wiersma, and today we're going to talk about this drawing that I made, a croquis drawing. And I did this one with the twin markers as well. I had uploaded about 2 or 3 weeks ago, I will have a link pop up, a tutorial about the twin markers, the first review. This is the second one, and for this time I thought it would be nice to draw a crow, and it was I really had fun making it, but I have to admit that the markers are not a medium that I really like, so therefore I may use it in the future again, but I don't think that often, at least. So therefore I really am happy to try this out. Now I know that the markers are not really my thing to make art with. But like I said, it was a fun little project, so therefore I thought that it would be nice to make a tutorial out of it and just talk about the twin markers, or the markers a little bit more. But before I start the tutorial, I want to point out one thing, and because the blacks on this crow are very, very dark, and I didn't have a real black in my set, so I had to mix up the color, but halfway through the painting, through the drawing, I thought, well, I need something that is really black, because it doesn't work really well. And therefore I grabbed my pigment liner. It's this one. It's not this. Yeah, it's just a brand I bought. There are different brands there, but this is really black, so therefore I could cover up the areas, the very dark areas, very easily. And it make a whole lot of difference for this drawing. So therefore, I thought I should mention that the rest is all done with the pigment with the markers, for the exception of the really dark blacks. So that's it and done. Let's start that tutorial. And in my first attempt to use the twin markers, I use the Yupo paper. For this one, I am using the Strathmore Bristol paper. And if I don't forget, I will have a link in the video description so you can check the paper out and the brand. But the big difference between the papers was that this paper, the Bristol paper, does soak the ink from the markers very strongly, of at least in my opinion, in comparison to the Yupo paper. The Yupo paper you can blend a little bit more, a little bit easier with the markers than on the Bristol paper, because like I said, it takes the ink from the markers quite quick. But therefore, on the other hand, you may get some nice results with that. But for me, I'm not gonna use the markers that often, like I said in the intro, so therefore it doesn't change much. But I think I would prefer this paper, the Bristol paper, if I really had to choose. And I started laying in my drawing. Here and there I'm using the eraser. Normally I skip this part because of that, because you see me erase stuff and then draw in stuff again, and it takes up quite some time, but this is a little fun project, so therefore I thought, well, I'm gonna show it to you. This is basically how I draw my drawings, and normally I do this on a piece of paper and then I transfer my images onto the canvas. And especially for painting, it's very nice to use this method. And I have to say, this method comes from Lockery Fine Art. And I think it's a really good way to keep your workspace as clean as possible. So therefore, you see me always use those white lines on paintings. That is because I trace my drawing onto the canvas. So first, I like to draw on a separate piece of paper, and I can use that paper again and again and again. But for this it wasn't necessary. Like I said, it's just a little fun project, so therefore I have some sketchy lines in there. I'm not very focused on the details. I just want to get a feel of the twin markers again, and also on this paper. And I thought, well, I'm just starting to build up my layers, my colors, as I would in a painting. So I start out with quite some different colors there, not even that much, but as you can see, I use some blues, some grays, and some purples I will use, and some really dark grays to lay in the darker areas, and also some brown color you see me use there on his neck. And if you mix the brown with blue, you will get a black or a blackish color. That's not an actual term, but you will get a black color. But like I said in the intro, it wasn't dark enough for me. You will see the difference later on this tutorial. It really make a lot of difference when I started to use that black from the liner. I would say liner brush. No, the liner pencil. Liner pen, I'm sorry. It's called, and that really was needed for this project to let it stand out more. And also I did choose not to use a background for this one to let it stand out the crow even more. So therefore I let the background be white. And I'm trying using different techniques. You see me using here a paintbrush. On the paintbrush I have some alcohol, some rubbing alcohol, just to see if I can blend the colors again. I can reactivate the colors with that alcohol, with the rubbing alcohol. But it didn't work very well, so therefore I skipped that part later on. But just like I said, I'm trying new things here and trying different techniques and see if something is working and how well it's working. But that technique didn't work on this paper. On the upper paper it did, it reactivates, but on this paper it hardly reactivates anything there. So that's a different, you need a different approach. And I'm slowly building up my texture here, and I'm drawing in the idea of different feathers. I'm not building up as much detail, but just the indication of feathers there. And once again, I like to use quite a lot of different colors to keep my details there and to get quite some variation in my drawings. And I really did like the brush tip on the markers. That one I'm really a fan of, so maybe for some project I will use those again, but they don't work for me very well. I don't enjoy them as much. But a nice thing of using different or new art materials is that for me it kind of forced me to start somewhere over again, starting making art over again. Get out your comfort zone. That is basically what I'm trying to say here. Because when you are used to painting, for me, and that's my case, I like to paint a lot with acrylic paints, for example. I'm really comfort using those paints. I'm really getting the experience over the years now. I kind of know what I can expect with different colors, how they work with one another, and different brushes, and etc. But when you start out using a very different art material you never used before, you kind of need to rediscover some techniques, and probably you need different techniques because it's not paint, it's a different art material, and therefore it encouraged me to try different approaches, and that helps when I start painting again, because some different colors I may use for this drawing, for example, I really liked how those two work, of those colors work together. So I may want to use that in my painting again, for just an example, or how the feathers came up in this drawing. Maybe I like that approach and I'd like to try that on my paints, or kind of similar there. So that's why I like to once in a while use different art materials, just to encourage myself and to try to think basically out of the box, basically out of my comfort zone. And I think it's very handy, because if you only work with a few mediums and you get really experienced with them, that is nice. But sometimes a little bit of a different approach may be very, very useful. So therefore I keep kind of track of myself and try keep on learning. And this is a way that helps me learning, keeps helping me learning. Which is kind of hard now, but I think you get a point. And here I was using my pencils and my color pencils, and they didn't work out as well. I used the black color pencils and I was hoping for that dark black, but then I grabbed that fine liner pen, and as you can see, that is a very, very dark black, and it helps getting the drawing a lot more interesting, very, very well. really helps to let it pop out even more and get those darks in, so the other sections will stand out a little bit more, of actually quite a bit more if you ask me. But you can see the difference here. I'm slowly building up that black, and I'm like I said, I really really did like that. But that dark black I don't have within the twin marker set. Probably it is there, but I don't have it. I don't know. But this is the end piece. Once again, it's just not it's not my best artwork, but it is a really fun project, and I personally like drawing and painting crows, so therefore I chose this subject for this tutorial. My next tutorial will be about a painting, quite a large painting with also a Scottish Highlander. Last week I did upload a tutorial about Terra. I will have a link pop up in the screen, so you can check it out if you didn't already have saw that tutorial. But I will work on a quite a large canvas, and also quite a lot of airbrushing will be included. So therefore I'm really looking forward to finish the painting and to show it with you guys. This was just a little fun project, and I will on occasionally do a little bit more of these kind of projects. But for now, I will start painting again, and just your regular acrylic base paints that I really like. So therefore, I hope to see you at next on my next tutorial. And if you didn't, maybe you want to subscribe to my channel. I try to upload every week new tutorials. And so yeah, therefore I hope to you will join my channel here. Thank you for watching, and like I said, I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye bye!